Hello, I'm Graham Steele, CEO and founder of Cryptosense, and today I'm going to talk about Java keystores, and particularly the JKS keystore. So what is a Java keystore? So a keystore is essentially a file that you're going to write to a file system that contains some cryptographic key material. So keystores came very early into Java, right from Java version 1.2, they're there. And you needed them at this point because it was in the mid-90s and various uses of cryptography were starting to take off. So SSL, which is now TLS, the main protocol for encrypting traffic across the network, particularly on web traffic, was starting to take off, as were considerations around things like code signing. So checking that code was really made by the right author before we execute it. And so to do either SSL TLS or to do code signing, you need a PKI, you need a public key infrastructure. So you need pairs of keys, public keys and private keys that correspond to each other so that we can work out whether we're really speaking to the right people that we think we're going to. And in particular, you need to store those keys. So you need to store public key certificates, so certificates that tell you who a public key really belongs to, and you need to store private keys somewhere that you can get to them. So if you're going to store keys in a file, keys for a PKI, there's typically two things you're concerned about straight away. One thing is that the private keys, the values of the private keys, are very sensitive. If somebody gets hold of those, they can typically do very nasty things and make attacks. So you might have seen recently on this channel, we talked about the Mimecast certificate attack, where a private key was compromised and used as part of an attack on their customers. So really, we need to be very, very careful about these private keys. So probably you're going to want to find a way to encrypt or protect those private keys. And secondly, you want to do something about the public key certificates. In particular, you want to make sure that nobody tampers with your public key certificate. So nobody gives you a public key that isn't the right one that you're then going to trust as and really believe that when you're talking to somebody on the internet that it really is the person you think it is. It's the certificate that tells you that it is. So if somebody gives you a false certificate, that could trick you into exchanging sensitive data with the wrong person. So that means you want to apply to your keystore file some kind of integrity check. So some way of being sure that nobody has tampered with that store since you sort of signed off on it or agreed that it was the right one. So the way this works in the JKS keystore is quite interesting because the JKS was designed back in the mid 90s where it was very difficult to export cryptography. It was difficult to export software that contained strong cryptography. So the Java designers were looking for a way to get this encryption and integrity, but without using strong cryptographic functions. So the way it works in the JKS keystore is you have a password for the keystore, an encryption password. And the way I'm going to use that password to encrypt the private keys is I'm going to hash that password using a hash function SHA-1. So hash functions at this time you could export, there was no problem about that. So I've got the SHA-1 hash function. I'm going to hash the password, I'm going to hash a salt, and then I'm going to continue to iterate over that to get a long stream of random looking bits. And then I'm going to XOR those bits against the value of the private key before I write it into the file for the keystore. So right away you can see that this isn't really very strong cryptography for various reasons. One is that you can flip bits in a predictable way and have that affect the outcome of the result of the public key. So when you decrypt the private key, you get back a value that I can manipulate by flipping with the bits. It could be allows various kind of nasty attacks. But also it's very, very easy to brute force guess the password for one of these key stores. So for every new password guess, I only have to do a single SHA-1 operation, which is a very, very fast operation, and then do an XOR against the first bits of the private key value of the key store, where the private key is, which has a particular format already because the private key is ASN1 encoded, so there's some redundant data at the beginning that tells me this is about to be a private key. And I can very quickly check whether I've got the right guess or not. And so this is basically an extremely weak key store. So we actually published a paper about this back in 2017. A very well-known password breaking program called Hashcat actually integrates a module specifically for breaking JKS key stores that takes advantage of these particular quirks and can do that cracking very, very, very fast. So as a result, in the Oracle Java update at the end of 2017, they made various changes that included essentially deprecating the JKS keystore because of this weak encryption. So that if you try and create one now with the key tool, so that typically the way you create one of these keystores is with Java's own key tool, it will tell you to try and choose another type because this type is not secure. There's another little quirk, which is in the integrity checking. So the way integrity checking works is that I take a hash over the entire key store, including all the public keys, which are in the clear, they're not encrypted, and the private keys, and the password, and also a little magic string. So a string which is in fact an ASCII encoding of mighty Aphrodite. So why it says mighty Aphrodite, I'm not quite sure, but I do know that there was a Woody Allen film of the same name. Came out in cinemas in about 1995, might have been around the time that the JKS was being designed. That perhaps that explains why that string is in there. Anyway, you take the hash over this string and the password and the whole of the key store, and that's what gives you your integrity check. So again, this is not a very cryptographically strong construction for integrity checking. You could imagine if you can do some manipulations with the end and truncate the key store. You could perhaps do some nasty things. In fact, you probably can't get away with that in this case, except under very specific circumstances because of the way that the format is created. But still, it also allows you to do very quick brute force guessing of the integrity password, because you only need to hash, make enough hash functions to cover the length of the key store. So unless the key store is extremely large, you can check each one of your guesses extremely fast. So it's a very weak way to do integrity checking as well. So anyway, the upshot is JKS key stores, even though they are everywhere, so when we did our survey back in 2017, we found that 70% of key stores used in GitHub projects were JKS key stores. So even though they're everywhere, they're what's used by default in a lot of application frameworks like Oracle WebLogic or WebSphere or Tomcat. You might have these JKS key stores lurking around all over the place. They're very tooled up for things like certificate renewal and so on. They're actually really not secure. So you should be looking at getting rid of these and using something more secure if you're going to use a key store. And we'll talk about some alternatives in some later videos. Or even not using key stores at all. If you're starting to deploy in the cloud, why not put those certificates in a secret store or something like that? We've got more videos about those things. You can find out more. So that's the story of the JKS key store. In the rest of the series, we're going to go through the different kinds of key stores. There are available and alternatives and each one of them and their quirks and whether you should be using them or not and what have you. So make sure you subscribe to the channel. That way you'll get notifications on these as they come out. Otherwise, we're going to put some links in the comments there where you can find out more about the JKS key stores, how to break them and how to migrate away from them. So thanks very much, and I hope to see you again very soon here on the channel.